So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs. And in today's session, as usually, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams and all the government exams, whether central government exam or the state government exam or the banking exam, कहीं से भी किसी भी exam में PIB जो है is the most authentic source for the current affairs. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says, in which state Mukhya Mantri Ghasiyari Kalyan Yojana has been launched by Union Home Minister Amit Shah? कौन से स्टेट में मुख्यमंत्री घसियारी कल्याण योजना लॉन्च हुआ है? सो जनरली गाइस, पीआईबी में स्टेट स्कीम्स का जिक्र नहीं होता है. जनरली देयर इज नो मेंशन ऑफ स्टेट स्कीम्स इन द पीआईबी, बट दिस स्कीम वाज मेंशन बिकॉज़ दिस वाज लॉन्च्ड बाय यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर अमित शाह ड्यूरिंग हिज विजिट टू उत्तराखंड एंड देयर वर टू अदर लॉन्चेस आल्सो. ठीक है, सो दैट इज व्हाई आई हैव टेकन दिस क्वेश्चन. सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज. सो द अमित शाह यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर द यूनियन होम मिनिस्टर अमित शाह visited Uttarakhand and there he launched three initiatives. Number one, computerization of all the primary agricultural credit societies. So all the PACS across Uttarakhand has now been computerized. ठीक है, जितने भी primary agriculture credit society हैं Uttarakhand के, वो सारे के सारे अब computerized हो चुके हैं and this will definitely help in direct linkage of PACS with district banks, district banks with state cooperatives bank and state cooperative banks with NABARD. And this will also help guys in providing the benefits of various government schemes to the actual beneficiaries. And इससे क्या होगा, जो middlemen हैं वो eliminate हो जाएंगे and the actual beneficiaries will get the desired benefits. All right. Number two, he has launched Mukhyamantri Ghasiyari Kalyan Yojana and the objective guys of this yojana, of this scheme, is to eliminate the difficulties faced by women in providing fodder for animals. ठीक है, जो animals हैं उनके लिए fodder provide कराने में जो भी difficulties होती हैं, this will be eliminated through this योजना, through this scheme. Okay, and under this scheme, animal feed will be given at the rate of 2 rupees per kg on 30% subsidy. ठीक है, and this will definitely eliminate the problems which are being faced by women in providing fodder to their animals. All right. Number three, there was an inauguration of cooperative training center, and as the name suggests, this training center will provide training to the cooperatives, and thereby this training will strengthen these cooperatives. All right, so these are the three launches that were done during the Amit Shah's visit to Uttarakhand. So now let's come back to the question. The correct answer should be what, guys? Uttarakhand, option D, because this scheme belongs to Uttarakhand. And remember guys, in today's session there are 5 questions. I am not taking a lot of questions because I believe you guys are busy in your Diwali celebrations. I have observed that in the previous 2-3 videos you guys are not watching those videos, but don't worry, everything will be covered. Aaj hum, kyunki abhi Diwali ka mahol chal raha hai and kal bhaiya dooj bhi hai, kai logo ke yahan pe hota hai, in fact pure northern India mein hota hai, so uski wajah se aaj keval 5 questions hain. But don't worry, every news will be covered. It's my responsibility, it's my duty. तो इसलिए मैंने आज कम रखा है ताकि आप लोगों के ऊपर ज्यादा प्रेशर ना आए. And it is good. ठीक है, don't worry. Celebrate Diwali, celebrate everything with great zeal and great enthusiasm. कोई दिक्कत नहीं है. 2-4 दिन का gap चलता है. It's okay to have gaps. But yes, ये जो celebration है, इसको अपने सर पे मत चढ़ाना. इसको हमें खत्म भी करना है. ठीक है, जैसे ही दिवाली खत्म होती है उसके बाद हमें back to work होना ही पड़ेगा. Otherwise it will, you know, affect your studies a lot. So ऐसा हमें नहीं करना है. And yes, let me tell you this, कि all the 5 news are very very important. Don't think that I'm taking 5 news and it is just a formality for you. ऐसा कुछ नहीं है. 5 के 5 questions बहुत ज़्यादा important है. ठीक है? और ज़्यादा इसलिए नहीं है, मैं फिर बता रहा हूँ, क्योंकि आपके ऊपर load ना है. Number 2 question. National Commission for Women headed by Rekha Sharma, she is the chairperson of National Commission for Women in collaboration with National Legal Services Authority, which in short is NALSA, has launched a legal awareness program for women, which is titled as Empowerment of Women through Legal Awareness. The question is, from where this program has been launched? This is again a very important question, because these days government is talking, in fact, the international community is talking much more about the empowerment of women. So that is why this question becomes very important. So the question is, kahan se ye program launch hua hai? Remember, this program has been launched, guys, from Varanasi. Varanasi, which is of course in Uttar Pradesh, and Varanasi is also the constituency of our Prime Minister. Okay? And Varanasi mein bhi recently ek Rudraksh building launch hui thi in collaboration with Japan. Okay. Now let's talk about this news. So National Commission for Women, headed by Rekha Sharma, in collaboration with NALSA, has launched this legal awareness program, which is titled as Empowerment of Women Through Legal Awareness. Do remember the title also. And as the name of the program suggests, this program is to impart practical knowledge about legal rights and remedies to women. Unke jo bhi legal rights hain, jo bhi legal remedies hain, how they can redress their grievances legally, un sabhi ke baare mein unko jankari di jayegi. And this program has been launched from Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. And also remember, this program will be, you know, ye jo legal awareness program hai, iske through Pan India awareness generate ki jayegi. Matlab, it is a Pan India program. Alright, but on 15th August 2020, in the month of August 2020, the program was launched as a pilot project in all the districts of 8 states. Kaun-kaun se 8 state? Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Assam. Okay. So it was launched as a pilot project in all the districts of 8 states, but now it has been launched across the country. Alright, and it was launched from Varanasi, Uttar Pradesh. So I already told you the answer. The correct answer is what? Varanasi. It has been launched from Varanasi in Uttar Pradesh. Question number 3 pe chalte hain. A webinar on affordability and innovation, ensuring quality drugs for all, has been organized by National Pharmaceutical Pricing Authority. Who chaired the webinar? This is again, guys, very important question. In this webinar, the discussions were there regarding how we can provide affordable medicines to the people of India. Kis tarike se hum jo people of India hai, citizens of India hai, unko affordable medicines provide kara sakte hain. Regarding that, we have a scheme also, Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Pariyojana. So in that also, the government is providing affordable medicines. Jo bhi mehengi mehengi medicines hoti hain, wo ek affordable cost ke affordable cost pe citizens ko provide ki jati hai through the Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Yojana. And to expand this possibility, this affordability, this webinar was held and discussions were there. And remember, this webinar was chaired by Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India, who is Professor K. Vijay Raghavan. K. Vijay Raghavan is the Principal Scientific Advisor to the Government of India. So option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4. Again, Union Home Minister and Minister of Cooperation Amit Shah has launched Dairy Sahakar scheme to provide support to cooperatives in dairy sector. Very, very important question. If I talk about the upcoming NABARD mains exam, jo NABARD mains aa raha hai, usme samjho ki ye question to, I believe 99% chances hai this question will come in your exam. Alright. If matlab jo ESI wala part hai, usme economics and social issues wala, usme they ask questions from the government schemes. So this question has a huge chance to come in your NABARD mains exam. How much investment will be done under this scheme? ठीक है, कितना इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाएगा? सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द स्कीम. द ऑब्जेक्टिव, गाइस, ऑफ द स्कीम इज टू प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट टू कोऑपरेटिव्स इन द डेयरी सेक्टर. ठीक है, दैट इज क्लियर फ्रॉम द नेम इटसेल्फ. व्हाट इज द नेम? डेयरी सहकार, व्हिच मींस दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डेयरी सेक्टर. एंड सहकार मींस व्हाट? कोऑपरेटिव्स. सहकार मींस व्हाट? कोऑपरेटिव्स. सो इट इज वेरी क्लियर दैट द सपोर्ट इज बीइंग प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस, सपोर्ट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस स्कीम टू द डेयरी कोऑपरेटिव्स. नाउ व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सपोर्ट इज दिस? The financial support will be provided to the eligible cooperatives. Financial support will be provided to the eligible cooperatives for various activities like bovine development, milk procurement, processing, quality assurance, value additions, packaging, marketing, transportation, export of dairy products, etc., etc. So basically, in all the spheres, they will be provided support. They ka matlab kaun hai yahan pe? Eligible dairy sector, eligible dairy manufacturers, or you can say eligible dairy sector mein jo bhi log kaam kar rahe hain, wo sabhi log. Alright. Now remember, the nodal agency for this scheme is National Cooperative Dairy Corporation, and total 5000 crore rupees will be invested in this particular scheme. 5000 crore rupees mein invest kiye jayenge. Alright. Do remember the nodal agency, very, very important, NCDC, and 5000 crore rupee investment is also the very important. And also remember, this scheme was launched by Union Home Minister Amit Shah on the occasion of 75th anniversary of Amul, ठीक है? Amul की जो 75th anniversary थी, उस दौरान the scheme was launched. So that's why, guys, the correct answer should be option B, rupees 5,000 crore, because they're asking about how much investment will be done under the scheme. So the total investment that will be done is how much? 5,000 crore. And the nodal agency, NCDC. Alright. Moving ahead to question number 5. Name the app that has been launched by Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment to facilitate the service for grievance redressal and new registration for the Divyangjan and senior citizen beneficiaries of ELIMCO. ELIMCO stands for Artificial Limbs Manufacturing Corporation. Artificial Limbs Manufacturing Corporation. It is a Mini Ratna. Under Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is headed by Dr. Virendra Kumar. Dr. Virendra Kumar is the minister. And remember, the objective of ELIMCO is to manufacture assistive living devices for senior citizens and Divyang Jan. And Mr. D.R. Sarin is the CMD, is the current CMD of ELIMCO. And the name of guys of this app is ELIMCO Mitra. Option C. ELIMCO Mitra. Through this app, the senior citizens and the Divyangjans can redress their grievances. Alright. So, and this app, remember, is absolutely free of cost, available on all the Android phones. So that's it for the session today, and I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And as I said, ki dekho, Diwali aa rahi hai, Diwali जा चुकी है इनफैक्ट अब, और अभी पूरा का पूरा जो वीक था ये पूरा दिवाली में निकला है आप लोगों का. एंड कल जो है भैया दूज है, सो कल के बाद से आई बिलीव कि यू गाइज विल बी बैक टू डू वर्क. एंड नबार्ड मेंस वालों को तो इतना टाइम नहीं लेना चाहिए, बिकॉज 16-17 तारीख को ही दोनों एग्जाम है. सो प्लीज डू नॉट यू नो वेस्ट टू मच टाइम. एक टाइम डिसाइड कर लो कि यस दिवाली के दिन या आगे आने वाले एक दो दिन में भी हमें इतना इतना पढ़ना है, ठीक है? तो हमेशा याद रखो कि सेलिब्रेशंस जो हैं वो आपके मेन काम में हिंड्रेंस नहीं बनना चाहिए. ओके, एंड थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग गाइज. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.